Hello everyone, I greet in the name of God Almighty. My name is Apostle Newton Silas, and today we have a very interesting Quranic recitation to react to by Abdullah Al-Musa, a common Quran recitation. I believe that this is going to be a very interesting video, and we all are going to learn from this. So if we get down to the video and check it out, we can be able to know what it's all about. So if today happens to be the first time of you checking out my channel, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and follow me on my Facebook and Instagram. And if you have any video you want me to react to, don't forget to drop it at the comment section and I'm going to check it out. So let's get down to this video and check this out.
أقم الصلاة لدلوك الشمس إلى غسق الليل وقرآن الفجر إن قرآن الفجر كان مشهودا ومن الليل فتهجد به نافلة لك عسى أن يبعثك ربك مقاما محمودا وقل رب أدخلني مدخل صدق وأخرجني مخرج صدق واجعل لي من لدنك سلطانا نصيرا وقل جاء الحق وزهق الباطل إن الباطل كان زهوقا وننزل من القرآن ما هو شفاء للمؤمنين وننزل من القرآن ما هو شفاء ورحمة للمؤمنين ولا يزيد الظالمين إلا خسارا وإذا أنعمنا على الإنسان أعرض ونأى بجانبه وإذا مسه الشر كان يئوسا قل كل يعمل على شاكلته فربكم أعلم بمن هو أهدى سبيلا ويسألونك عن الروح قل الروح من أمر ربي وما أوتيتم من العلم إلا قليلا ولئن شئنا لنذهبن بالذي أوحينا إليك ثم لا تجد لك به علينا وكيلا إلا رحمة من ربك إن فضله كان عليك كبيرا قل لئن اجتمعت الإنس والجن على أن يأتوا بمثل هذا القرآن لا يأتون بمثله ولو كان بعضهم لبعض ظهيرا ولقد صرفنا للناس في هذا القرآن من كل مثل فأبى أكثر الناس إلا كفورا قالوا لن نؤمن لك حتى تفجر لنا من الأرض ينبوعا أو تكون لك جنة من نخيل وعنب فتفجر الأنهار خلالها تفجيرا أو تسقط السماء كما زعمت علينا كسفا أو تأتي بالله والملائكة قبيلا أو يكون لك بيت من زخرف أو ترقى في السماء ولن نؤمن لرقيك حتى تنزل علينا كتابا نقرأه قل سبحان ربي هل كنت إلا بشرا رسولا وما منع الناس أن يؤمنوا إذ جاءهم الهدى إلا أن قالوا أبعث الله بشرا رسولا قل لو كان في الأرض ملائكة يمشون مطمئنين لنزلنا عليهم من السماء ملكا رسولا قل كفى بالله شهيدا بيني وبينكم إنه كان بعباده خبيرا بصيرا. ومن يهد الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد لهم أولياء زدناهم سعيرا. ذلك جزاؤهم بأنهم كفروا بآياتنا وقالوا أئذا كنا عظاما ورفاتا أئنا لمبعوثون خلقا جديدا. أولم يروا أن الله الذي خلق السماوات والأرض قادر على أن يخلق مثلهم وجعل لهم أجلا لا ريب فيه فأبى الظالمون إلا كفورا. قل لو أنتم تملكون خزائن رحمة ربي إذا لأمسكتم خشية الإنفاق وكان الإنسان قتورا. ولقد آتينا موسى 9 آيات فاسأل بني إسرائيل إذ جاءهم فقال له فرعون إني لأظنك يا موسى مسحورا. قال لقد علمت ما أنزل هؤلاء إلا رب السماوات والأرض بصائر. قال لقد علمت ما أنزل هؤلاء إلا رب السماوات والأرض بصائر وإني لأظنك يا فرعون مثبورا. فأراد أن يستفزهم من الأرض فأغرقناه ومن معه جميعا. وقلنا من بعده لبني إسرائيل اسكنوا الأرض فإذا جاء وعد الآخرة جئنا بكم لفيفا. وبالحق أنزلناه وبالحق نزل وما أرسلناك إلا مبشرا ونذيرا. وقرآنا فرضناه لتقرأه على الناس على مكث ونزلناه تنزيلا. قل آمنوا به أو لا تؤمنوا إن الذين أوتوا العلم من قبله إذا يتلى عليهم يخرون للأذقان سجدا. ويقولون سبحان ربنا إن كان وعد ربنا لمفعولا. ويخرون للأذقان يبكون ويزيدهم خشوعا. قل ادعوا الله أو ادعوا الرحمن أيما تدعوا فله الأسماء الحسنى. ولا تجهر بصلاتك ولا تخافت بها وابتغ بين ذلك سبيلا. وقل الحمد لله الذي لم يتخذ ولدا ولم يكن له شريك في الملك ولم يكن له ولي من الذل وكبره تكبيرا.
That's a very interesting video, learning about this calming recitation. Of course, we have looked at people from different dispensation and their encounter with God, their disobedience, and some of the consequences they face. We look at the jinn, for instance, when they fall, you understand, out of, you understand, God's hands, the consequences of their action and what, you understand, that befall them. Of course, example of the jinn, we can talk about, you understand, the devil, that's the shaitan. Of course, we could see how he fall out of God's hands and his punishment, and how he was being condemned to eternal hellfire. We also look at Pharaoh, of course, that proved to be very stubborn, and then we look at his punishment on how God was able to drown him for his disobedience. I and you are here in this very dispensation. God have sent his message to his messengers, to the Muslim, of course, they have received, you understand, the Quran, the Christians have received the Bible. All those scriptures, you understand, are there to guide us and then to make sure that we live in accordance to God's will, so that we should not go against him. Of course, just like the way we have seen of people of time past have done the same thing, and then the consequences of their action is now left for you and I to decide for ourselves. For us to also understand that there is judgment, and if you understand, we are to stand before our Maker, what will be our own account? For what we do here on this very earth, can it be able to save us from eternal hellfire? This is the questions for me and you to be able to answer. Of course, we understand ourselves, we cannot deceive ourselves. We know what we do and we know what we do not do, so we can be able to like tell for ourselves. Of course, if you are for God, you already know, and if you are not of God, you already know. But one thing that differentiates us, you understand, from the jinn, or shall I say from Pharaoh, because those ones have already stand condemned already, but we already have, or we just have an opportunity in the sense that as far as we still breathe, we still have this life, we still have opportunity of repentance. And that's why immediately we realize that we are fall short of God's glory, then we go before him and seek for forgiveness. For he has said in his word that he is just, that he is going to forgive us of our unrighteousness once we fall short of his glory. So it's just the prayer for me and you is for us to return back to our Maker. You know, the right time that we should always go to God is when we actually sin, and not that when we sin then we decide to go away from him. For that's the antics that the devil used to destroy God's children. And it's not my prayer for you and I for us to get destroyed to eternal hellfire, so that on the last day we can be able to see our Maker for who he is. For that happens to be the ultimate goal. All these scriptures that was given, they are just there for correction, to rebuke us, and then to what? To direct us, to train us in all righteousness. So everything, you understand, that is here for all these scriptures is just here on this very earth. And the Bible have already made us to understand that we are being made what? Perfect in Christ Jesus. It means that on our own, we can't be able to make it, and that's why we always seek for God's mercy upon us. For it is because of his mercy that still keep me and you alive today, and that's why it is a good thing for us to turn to our Maker, seek for forgiveness, and we all pray for his guidance so that we can make it to eternity. So guys, this is the end of my video. If you like my reaction, if you like, share and subscribe, and if you have any video you want me to react to, don't forget to drop it at the comment section, and I'm going to check it out. So guys, you remain blessed, and I see you in my next video. Bye bye.